touch my skin and left your mark. You knew all the words to say. Held the strings tied to my heart. Pulled and pushed away. Friends don't bring you up no more. I'm sure yours don't mention me. I remember how we were before.
We are unhooked.
What can I get?
Good morning, guys, and welcome back to the video. Today is the Montgomery Bell Cross Country Mountain Bike Race. I stayed at the Mont Bell State Park. We're about 2 miles from the trailhead, so I've headed there this morning. It's 10 till 8. My race doesn't start till 9-ish, so I've got plenty of time this morning. So I'm not too rushed at all, which is so nice. Actually, hang on a second. Go ahead and start drinking my V8 Energy. This is the orange pineapple. It's the best flavor. This is generally how I get my caffeine in for races. If you guys watched one of my older videos, I drink coffee in the winter, but in about the springtime when racing really kicks up for me, I actually quit drinking coffee. And the reason why I do that is that I like to make myself more sensitive to caffeine. So that way when I drink this one little drink before the race, I feel the effects of it a lot more than if I was a regular coffee drinker. As I mentioned in the previous video, I only race 2 laps, so about 20 miles a day. I'm pretty sure I kick off with the Cat 2 women. So I don't know if there's any other women here to race, so I guess I'll just race the other Cat 2 woman that's here, my friend Dina. People are probably wondering, how did I sleep in the van last night? No problems, slept very well, it was very comfortable. The biggest issue is figuring out how to regulate the temperature, and that's just something that I'll have to learn over time. Because of the fact that there's no thermostat in the van, I didn't run the AC last night. What I do is that there's this fan up here and I set it to pull air out, and I open the window beside me in the bed, and so it pulls air right across the bed and out that fan. It gets a really good breeze going. The problem is figuring out what to set that to throughout the night so that I don't get too cold. So the issue was that I had to adjust a little bit. It's about 30 minutes before the race starts, so I'm gonna switch over to the GoPro at the beginning of the race. I'm just gonna go ahead and start my warm-up now. Had a lot of people come up and ask about the van and ask to see in it, so that's been pretty cool. All right, guys, let's get started on the commentary for this mountain bike cross-country race. Now, the USAC official gave me like a 15-second warning, and I was expecting like a 10 or a 5-second notice, and all I got was a whistle blow at the time to go, so I was really startled off the line, didn't clip in very well, and that's why you see my poor start. On top of that, the girl in first and the girl in second, they're both juniors. The girl in first got an awesome start. I mean, she shot right off the line there. And I had no clue who those two girls were. And since Cat 1 and Cat 2 women started together, I did not know if they were in my category or not. So I made a lot of bad assumptions right off the race. And I usually like to know who I'm racing against if I can. And not having any clue, I feel like I underestimated the girl in first place just a little bit. So we started off and they're keeping a pretty good pace here. And you have to start to think, like, people like to start off fast in a lot of races and then they will settle into their pace. And so you have to decide to go with them, even if you're burning a match. Can you go with them? Can you sustain that pace, or will it cause you to bonk later in the race? I was feeling fine here. It wasn't too much above my pace, so I just went with them. But I know this, I've ridden this trail a couple times, but I don't know it really well. It's been 2 years since I've been here, but I do know that there's a lot of climbing. So you don't want to, you know, use all your fuel so early on into the race when you've got all these epic climbs later on. I say they're epic, they're not that epic. But anyways, I end up getting around the girl in second place not too long from here, further in the trail. And so I'm watching the girl in first place because I'm like, man, she's flying. I'm like, she's really going. I'm thinking in my head, she knows this course, because she's not, like, I feel like when I come down a descent, I brake too much because there's a turn and I don't know what the turn's like. I don't know where I'm going. But I feel like she was riding those descents much smoother than me. That's just something that I noticed.
Now, I was kind of trying to pay attention on the climbs to see if I was gaining time on her. That's something I like to do, is watch people to see how they climb, because I feel like I can be pretty good on climbs. And so if I know I can make up time there, it will make me push just a little bit more up those climbs to get a couple more seconds. And I did notice that just a little bit. But I was getting some time splits from people. There were a couple Cat 2 men that I ended up passing. They started right in front of us. And one of the guys gave me a 30-second split, and then I gained some more time on her, and I was given a 15-second split. Well, what ended up happening is around the time I got that 15-second split, not too long before then, I had noticed my front tire was looking a little bit low. And I just kept thinking, I was like, man, I need to put air in that tire. But there was like not a good place to stop and do that. And I was just, you know, working that process out in my head, like, how do I do this? And about that time, I went down this dip that had some rocks in it and came back up, and I heard a noise like a rock hit my tire. And after that, it got pretty low. So I had to stop. And that is the girl behind me in third place passing me right there. And so I got my CO2 out, and I was like, you know, I checked the tire, saw where it was leaking, and I could see the sealant was trying to seal it. So I'm like, okay, I'm going to just put some air in it then, and we should be good to go. Well, my CO2 inflator wouldn't work. Andy from Stakey Creek Cycling actually stopped, threw me a CO2 inflator that had a CO2 cartridge in it. And so right here, what you see me doing is I'm plugging a piece of bacon in it. I call it a piece of bacon. They're like tire plugs, kind of like for your car. So I was thinking, okay, well, it's not sealing, so I'm going to put that bacon plug in there, and that helps the sealant seal it if it's a bigger hole. So I put that in there, and I start putting some CO2 in there, and I'm thinking, this is perfect. This is exactly like what I prepared for, what I planned. Now, disclaimer, I've never gotten a flat tire in a race before. Not once that I can think of. Now, I've gotten flat tires out riding, but obviously, that's a much more low-key situation. So now I've got some air in my tire. I'm going to set off, and I'm thinking, cool, I'm going to ride. The sealant's going to swash around in the tire. It's going to seal perfect, just like all the brand manufacturers tell you. You'll be back to racing. Now, that was a four-minute stop right there, at least 4 minutes. So I'm thinking, well, that cat one junior that was up front, she's gone. I'm not going to catch her. But I was like, I could still chase Dina down, the girl who had just passed me. I was like, maybe I can just, you know, keep going. This is a couple miles before the end of the first lap, so I've still got a whole nother lap to do. So I'm thinking I'm going to be good. Unfortunately, there's still air escaping my tire. So no, I'm not good. I decided that I better stop again. I'm going to add some more CO2 just to kind of top up the tire, because I'm thinking, okay, it's not fully sealed yet. It's still trying to seal. And so I just need to add a little bit more CO2. Now, since Andy gave me his CO2 inflator with a cartridge, I still had mine. So at this point now, I am using two CO2 cartridges on this bad boy. And I'm just hoping that that's all it is, that once I fill this guy up, we're going to continue on, be back to riding, and having a great time on our bikes. Unfortunately, I was wrong, and that CO2 was able to get me back to the start here, and I'm talking to the USA Cycling official, letting him know what's going on, and letting him know, going to my car, I'm going to try to fix this, and I'm going to start my second lap. So at this point, I know, okay, forget the podiums. I just want to finish this race. I just need to do one more lap. It's not that big of a deal. So I'm going to go up to the van, and I'm thinking, I'm going to get my pump out and pump it up and try to figure out where it's leaking from. So my teammate, Mason, he is Jamie's son. Jamie's also my teammate. They're just hanging out because Mason's race doesn't start for hours. And so they come over, and they're trying to help me, and Jamie actually takes my wheel off, and he finds that I had pinch flatted. So in a pinch flat, you're running too low of air, and something hits the tire and it smashes against the rim. And so it punctures, like you get a puncture near the bead and a puncture really close to that. And so I had found the puncture on top of the tire, but we discovered the one near the bead. So this is where, honestly, looking back at this, I make a critical mistake, okay? What we do at this point is we put the slice of bacon into the puncture that's near the bead, and we pump up the tire and we think it's good. The critical mistake is that I had a brand new tube in my toolbox right there in the van. I should have gotten that tube and just tubed that tire right then and there. Had I done that, I most likely would have finished that lap. But my race protocol has been to, number one, the sealant seals it. Like, that's your go-to. That's what you hope works. If that doesn't work, you've got the piece of bacon, the plug. You plug it, and the sealant seals it. Like, okay. And then the third thing, like, last worst case scenario, you put a tube in the bike. And I just wasn't thinking about putting a tube in it. Now, I carry a tube on my bike, but when you carry the tube underneath your saddle, they get ruined really easy and really quick. And I knew that that tube had been there a while and that it wasn't going to work. So I wasn't even thinking about that tube, but I had a fresh tube in the box, in my toolbox, right there in the back of the van. I should have put it in. But anyways, that's hindsight. That's just how it is. So they get me going, and a couple miles in, I'm in the same boat where it's just not holding air. And I actually decide to pull that tube off my bike and see if it will hold air. I just blow it up by mouth, and of course it doesn't. So what I realized, I kind of knew this before about myself, is that I'm not a quitter, and I really, 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 really did not want to quit this race. This is my first DNF in a race ever. And it really bothered me. It bothered me worse than losing. I would have preferred to come dead last and had finished this race than have had to quit. It bothered me that much. So knowing that makes me realize that I need to put more importance on carrying a tube with me during these races. I want to be as light as possible. So I think that's where the sealant and the plugs, like, those are light. A tube's heavy. But if not being able to finish, like, if not finishing bothers me that bad, then I need to carry the tube and just take that very small weight penalty. And like I said, I had a tube on my bike, so I felt like I was doing good, but I wasn't checking it to make sure it wasn't damaged. So I've been reevaluating my race protocol for this, and my plan is to carry a brand new tube with me for the race that isn't exposed to the elements on the back of my bike that I know that works. So yeah, that's just being a little bit more prepared, and I feel like a dummy. Honestly, I hope you guys don't think I'm a dummy, but I feel like one. Like, I should have done better, but I've known people in the past who, if they have to put a tube in their tire, they just quit because, well, that puts them so far back in the race that what's the point in continuing the race, you know? But I don't have that mentality. My mentality is, if I enter a race, I want to finish regardless of my place. You get dealt a hand of cards during this race, and how you handle that is, I feel like it's part of the character that you are. And so that's probably why it bothered me so bad, because I'm not a quitter. So anyways, that's what I learned from this race. And I'm glad that it happened at this event, at an event that didn't mean anything to me. I really wish I could have continued to battle with that Cat 1 Junior. She won the race. She was really fast. I checked some Strava segments later just to kind of see where we were at. And I was definitely competing with her. So it would have been a really good second lap, I think. So that's, honestly, that's the worst part about it, is not getting to have a battle with somebody like that. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.